think he's gonna be like a little horny, like.
Oh.
you know how happy you'd be. I mean, every guy dreams of finding a girl who looks like you. We both know why we're here. I see it in your eyes. I guess it calms my fear to know it's not a surprise. But one look at you, looking like a dream come true, would leave me speechless like you always do. But now we're wide awake. We've got some plans to make. Let's take some action, baby. So baby, give me your hand. I've got some dreams to make true. I've got the future all planned. It's time to get serious. Time to get serious with you.
I was 2 or 3. My life was planned out neat. I'd get my law degree and then win my Senate seat. A big White House back east. All of the amenities. Three kids at least, just like the Kennedys. Here's where our lives begin. But just where do you fit in? I'll break it down now, baby. So baby, give me your hand. I've got some dreams to make true.
I've got some dreams to make true.
To know that you'll understand.
Oh, yes, I understand. It's
time to get serious.
Time to get serious.
Serious. Time to wake up and take our journey. Serious.
It's worse.
It's worse, brother. Big money
This is what sense.
Cool. All right, welcome to Harvard Law, the hallowed halls of Harvard. I know how hard you all work to get here, so why don't we go around and share a bit about ourselves. Aaron Schultz.
I won a Fulbright out of Rose. I read financial software prose. But that's a challenge I love grown. How many yachts can one man own? Some say that I'm a pompous creep. Some call I don't lose that much sleep. Why bother with false modesty? Harvard's the perfect place for me.
Pretty impressive, good to know. Welcome to Harvard.
What's up?
Yo!
Sandeep Agarwal Panabali, but you may call me Your Majesty. In my country, my word was law, but then I flee because of stupid coup d'etat. But here I learn, I make new friends, and soon return in bulletproof Mercedes-Benz.
Pretty impressive,
good to know. Welcome to Eden Hoops. I did the Peace Corps overseas, inoculating refugees and family clinics that I built myself from mud and trees. I come to clean up their lagoons and save the rare endangered loons and let a protest march against insensitive cartoons.
Pretty impressive, good.
But now I'm on the legal track because this country's out of whack and only women have the guts to go and take it back. Make the government convene and get more people voting green and really stick it to the balance of the machine.
It is so petite chic. So, how psyched are you guys? Snacks! First day in Harvard Law!
I'm Al Woods, and this is Riverwood.
Enid.
Oh my god. We both have names that start with the letter E.
Oh my god. We're like practically twins.
My name's such a name, too. Well, we're just going around the circle. Why don't
me? Okay. So I'm a Gemini with a double Capricorn moon, and I have my bachelor's degree from UCLA, where I was stand up sweetheart and president of Delta Mu Sorority, and I founded the charity Shuck for a Cause. Huh. And just last week at Fred Siegel, I talked Beyonce into buying a completely heinous cableknit tube top. Whoever said tangerine is the new pink is seriously disturbed. Right, Georgia?
I did not know that.
Do you know where I can find Criminal Law 101 with Professor Callahan and also Warren Huntington III?
Well, yeah, maybe someone could... Guys, no. It's, Hauser, second building to the left.
Thanks.
I don't believe dogs are allowed in class.
Well, that's okay then, because Bruiser's not a dog. Bruiser's family. Bring it back to my room. You'd probably be happier there anyway.
Bruiser loves clean, right?
Yes. Bye.
Pardon me.
ruthless. He bathes in the blood of sheep. Blah, 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 blah. Well, only some of that's true. What you really need to know about him is that
you have the right to remain silent. Anything you say will be used against you. Now, when you choose a law career the moment you embark, there's that joke you're bound to hear. A lawyer is a shark. Ignore that. It's simplistic and it's dumb. Only some people turn out sharks, just some. The rest are chum. Our topic is blood in the water. Kids, it's time you faced. Law school is a waste. Oh yes, unless you acquire a taste for blood in the water. Dark and red and raw, you're nothing until the thrill of the kill becomes your only law. Mr. Schultz, my federal question. Would you defend the following banker accused of fraud? A kind old grandma took her savings and she sent it all to your client, all she saved since she was born. Well, he promised to invest it, but he spent it on prostitutes and heroin and porn.
No, I would not take that case.
Wrong, this one is a win unless you're lazy. Grandma Roach will have some hack from the middle age. Put her on the stand and pull her old and crazy. Your guy was free and you can get you high and laid. Look for the blood in the water. Read your Thomas Hobbes. Only spineless snobs will go with the morally dubious jobs. Yes, blood in the water. Sorcerers are up. Yes, Miss Hoops, hypothetical question. Would you be the right lawyer for the following client? Say they offer you a bundle for defending a famous hitman for the mafia in the seems he Mr. Joseph Gray killed an unnamed away, running over three puppies in the street.
What? You think I wouldn't defend him just because he's a typical man?
Oh, that's really funny. Yeah, clap it up. You lesbians think you're so tough.
What did you say?
I said you lesbians think you're so tough. Oh dear, I fear my comment is offended. Aren't you argue though when you're too mad to speak? Your employment will be very quickly ended when they see how your emotions. So what's my point? I run a billion-dollar law firm, and I hire 4 new interns every year. From this class, I will select 3 sharks whom I respect, and those 4 will have a guaranteed career. Do you follow me? So I want to see what? Exactly. Let the games begin. 4 of you will win. Or with that old bin, yes, blood in the water. So white and scratch and claw. Yes, miss.
What? Alvin?
Someone's had their morning coffee. Would you summarize the case of State of Indiana v. Hearn from your reading, please?
But I wanted to answer the puppy question.
Well, I'm asking you about the assigned reading.
Okay, well, who assigns a reading for the first day of class?
Yeah, that's what I'm talking about.
You have guts, Miss Woods. Ah, Miss Kensington. Let us say you teach a class at Harvard Law School, a position that you're justly proud of ours. But a girl on whom you called hasn't heard the case at all. Should you let her go?
No, I throw her out.
Huh. All right, then. You heard your classmate. You have just been killed. She cut your throat, so grab your coat. Yes, you got guts, but now they're spilled your blood in the blood.
Do what?
Us squirrels have to stick together. We can't make ourselves look good by making others look bad.
I didn't make you look bad. You just weren't prepared. Try opening a log sometime. But I better warn you, they don't come with pictures.
So, okay, I'll just leave it shredded.
Aren't your girls going wild somewhere without you?
Oh, Warner, thank God you're here.
Yeah, Elle, listen, I'm really sorry.
Bye, Warner.
Isn't there, like, something you want to show me?
Warner, do you know her?
Elle, Vivian and I went to boarding school together, and now she's my girlfriend.
Thank you.
she's serious.
Seriously, does she have any boobs?
No, she's a constipated polo shirt with a mousy brown long bob. But she's a foreigner once, so you have to make me a brunette.
Whoa, 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 whoa. Do you know the number one reason behind all dead hair decisions?
Love.
You're lost without your love. Your heart is on the floor. I can help you. I've been there before. When I need to relax, I just put on some tracks. From this CD I bought for the store. Isn't that relaxing? It's called Celtic Moon.
Oh,
and you fight for him.
Hello. Help? Is that you? Okay.
Hey, what's up, Jack?
Love.
Excuse me?
I put my faith in love. I followed where it led.
What'd you hear?
To my personal circle of hell. It has not worked out well. I wish that I were dead. Cause instead of the wedding and love, I'm flunking out of school, a total laughing stock. So when he and his friends can just mock, so go and use my head to get it on the rocks.
Wait. Go back. You came out here to follow a man. Harvard Law was just part of that plan. Man, what rich romantic planet are you from?
Malibu.
Instead of lying outside by the pool, you stalk some guy to an Ivy League school. That's the weirdest reason I've ever...
Well, why'd you come?
Okay. I grew up in the Roxbury slums with my mom and a series of bums. Guys who showed me all the ways a man can fail. I got through law school by busting my ass. I worked two jobs in addition to class. So forgive me for not leaving at your tail.
Well, excuse me, just because you have some sort of chip on your shoulder.
You know what? You're right. There's a chip on my shoulder, and it's big as a boulder. With the chance I've been given in, I'm gonna be driven as hell. I'm so close, action tasted, so I'm not gonna waste it. Yeah, there's a chip on my shoulder. You might want to get one as well.
I'm sorry, but that is highly negative.
Hey, I'm just being honest. When you weren't born into privilege, you gotta work twice as hard. Wear my sweatshirt back.
And two jobs plus law school?
Yeah, I've been substance in 1998.
How do you do it?
Well, I don't go to parties a lot. Not good use of the time that I've got. Can't spend hours doing my hair or staying in shape.
I don't spend hours.
But I know it'll all be worthwhile when I win my first lucrative trial and buy my mom that great big house out on the Cape. No, that's that chip on my shoulder. I hugged my mom and told her, with the chance I've been given, I'm gonna be driven as hell. Though I can't take the day off and just think of the payoff. You need a chip on your shoulder, little Miss Woods, come out.
I just need to prove to everyone that I am serious.
What you need to do is get to work.
Make yourself at home.
Started its life as a desk. Clear it off All right, define malum prohibitum.
Malum prohibitum is...
An act
prohibited by law, like jaywalking and chewing gum in Singapore.
Therefore, malum in se...
is an action that's evil in itself. Assault, murder, wet shoes after Labor Day.
Good.
I'm gonna get going.
Get going?
Yeah.
Where are you going?
Home, of course. It's Thanksgiving break, remember?
I see.
What?
Well, I predict you will probably pass
what?
The bottom percent of your class.
What?
If you're going for mediocre, don't agree.
That's not fair.
Well, they laughed at me like they're laughing at you. We cannot win if you don't follow through. Might I venture your vacation plans can wait?
Why do you always have to be right?
Why this sperm? I see your point.
And, by Mr. Huntington's standard, all not called reckless abandonment.
Miss Woods, you just won your case.
Oh my
God. Wait, hold on! You just won your case!
Months ago, I would recycle these. Make sure to put them on file.
Guess she's got a chip on her shoulder. Maybe some wise men told her. With the chance we've been given, we've gotta be driven as hell. She was something to see there. Of this happy eye could be there. First big test and she aced it. She's so good, she can take it.
Today. Ladies and gentlemen, I need the best and the brightest. Congrats to the choice of you, and as for the rest of you, welcome to the middle. Emmett, I'm going to make you my co-counsel on the Wyndham trial. Group yourself here, and the term associate isn't far off.
Yes, sir.
We start at Monday morning at 9 a.m. sharp. Please dress appropriately.
Emmett, that is so awesome. I'm so proud of you.
Yes, score!
We got Callahan's internship.
What?
It's just to be planned.
Oh, hey, this is just the beginning. It's perfect.
Make this the happiest day of my life.
Warner, it's absolutely stunning.
Marry me?
Yes. All of this time, I planned, I patient, and you love me then. Come to respect my mind, and at last you find you could love me again.
We've held a holiday present drive called Gifts from Garden Valley, where we collect monetary donations purchase gifts with these donations and provide needy children throughout the county and the district with presents for the holidays. In order to accomplish our goal, we have called upon faculty, staff, and students of Garden Valley School District to assist us. But we are also in need of your help. As you exit the theater for intermission, you will see students with red Santa hats pointing holiday bags. These are our peer counselor donation collectors, and we are asking you to please donate in any way possible. Any loose change, any cash, Lynn, I'm kidding, don't do that. But anything that would help support us and get these gifts for these children, we really would appreciate it. Thank you all so much, and please enjoy the rest of the show.
Thank you. Boston Women's Rental Facility does not mean we can't be the best that we can be! Here we go!
Thank you.
being a Maryland L? Listen, Pooh Bear. L. Callahan really wants that alibi. If you give it to him, you can sail through law school knowing there's a big, fat job offer waiting for you when you get out.
But I gave him my word.
So what? Who cares?
So what? Who cares?
Emmett, let me be very clear. This is your chance. I gave you simple instructions. Leave this legal team and get me an alibi. For 0.2. All right, everyone. Field trip's over. Let's go back to work. Except for you two. I'd rather not see a bratty corduroy or legally blonde again today.
I'm sorry.
Oh, I don't need you to be sorry. I need an alibi.
I can't tell it. I gave up my word. We can free her another way. We don't need the alibi.
No, I guess we don't, but it would sure help.
Let's free her the noble way.
Oh my gosh, Belle, I'm not interested in some Lifetime original movie. I'm not interested in nobility. I'm interested in saving Brooke's life.
Really? Because it seems as though you're more interested in impressing Callahan.
Well, he is my boss. Plus, if I impress him, he'll make me an associate.
And jeopardize our client's trust. And our integrity.
Okay, but, listen. Okay, well, why do you put it like that?
Exactly, you butthead.
Wow. No one's called me a butthead since the third grade, L.
Oh, maybe not to your face.
Why do you always have to be right?
I'm not. When I'm with you, I just am. If you want to impress Callahan, I'm out.
Okay, how?
Listen, I love your scrummy vibe, but Casual Friday is so not Callahan's vocabulary. You have to dress the part if you want to get ahead.
Elle, hasn't your mother ever taught you to not judge a book by its cover?
She did, and that's why books with tattered covers stay on the shelf.
Where's your friends on?
It's a tough world out there, Emmett. You don't think I haven't gotten judged my entire life? You don't think it was a good idea to make Navy my new pink?
No. This was a good idea.
I know.
Where are you taking me anyway?
You trust me, don't you?
Of course.
The boat stop now.
Thank you.
The outside is new, but now it reflects what's already in you. I couldn't change that if I wanted to, and I do not.
Thank you.
No. Thank you. This is a gift. It's payment of mine. As you saw me none of the want of my mind. But we've got to buy this. What are you buying? You look hot. Is he not hot? Here you become what you're supposed to be. You think you get what you get.
Right. I can't just
brought their floaties.
Cleaning the pool.
And could you please tell the court what exhibit A is?
That was my uniform.
And was it Brooks? I didn't have you wear this uniform?
Yes.
And could you please tell the court what your relationship was to the defendant?
Brooke and I were lovers.
Go either way.
Look at that condescending smirk. Seen them
Well, hello, Marilyn. Looks like you'll really make partner now. Whew, you sure earned it.
Or shut up.
Drive, that's my dream.
say? We can say we can fight this. Hell. What about love? I never mentioned love. The timing's bad, I know. But perhaps if I made it more clear that you belong right here, you wouldn't have to go. 'Cause you know that I'm so much in love.
Don't turn it wrong.
can't represent you in court.
Actually, she can, Your Honor. Rule 303 of the Supreme Judicial Court states that any law student, Miss Elwood, may represent a defendant in criminal proceedings.
Well, if she doesn't have a licensed attorney, she can't. She's still just a law student.
Actually, Your Honor, she can. I have a license. I will gladly supervise Miss Woods.
Like hell you will. You work for me, remember?
Oh, no. I work for myself, and I don't have to hit on interns, Professor!
Enjoy your prison.
Okay, bye.
I was just gonna like get away.
Miss Woods, any day now you may proceed. Call your first witness.
We call Chucky Wyndham to the stand.
Oh my God.
He's total tragic perm.
Now, Miss Wyndham, what was your relationship to the deceased? He was my father. And did you actually see his murder take place?
No, I was in the shower, but when I got out, Brooke was standing over my father's body, drenched in his blood.
Oh boy, we're screwed.
Don't listen to him, Ellie. You're doing fine. Keep going.
Miss Wyndham, on the day your father was murdered, did you see anyone suspicious hanging around?
Suspiciously hanging around my shower?
No, before that,
I was out getting a burn.
And then you came home and took a shower?
Yes, I was in the shower.
Your Honor, I would like to go to the bathroom.
Shouldn't you have gone before the murder trial?
No, I meant I would like us all to go to the bathroom together.
Oh, why do girls always do that?
I meant I would like us to go back to the bathroom where this alleged shower took place.
Oh, Miss Woods.
To think that I didn't take you seriously, I was wrong.
Thanks, Warner.
We do belong together. You show me who we can be. Together again.
Warner. Vivian dumped you, didn't she?
Practice is done. Yeah. Oh, cool. Okay. So, the first thank yous we'd like to give are to Mrs. Lyons and.
Yeah.
And my mom, Mary Jane. Into that because of the amount of people, the amount of costumes, and all of that, and my entire living room was pink by last week, so yeah, but it truly means a lot that they're here, and I couldn't be more thankful.
All right, cool. So I have both the honor and privilege to be able to thank these two super amazing gentlemen that help us a lot with our sets and our stage crew, Mr. Arters and Uncle Russ.
I give people sometimes a really hard time, but
know, this person keeps me in line, and I'm very thankful for Mrs. Arters. Without you... everyone in this club.
Thank you to all the parents in all the committees and all the people that come out and support us. Everyone sitting in these seats tonight, this is why we have these costumes, these sets, and these kids, and this music, and we really appreciate all the support you give us. Thank you very much. Have an awesome night.
Hey, welcome home.